As you might already know, input lag is responsible for the delay between what you do on your controller and when the action happens on screen. When it's bad, it can completely ruin your gaming session, and it's difficult to fix because it can come from a number of places. Let's review the possible causes for input lag and then we'll see how to fix it. Controller connection, network connection, Android device, and your TV device. Your controller could be partially responsible for a bit of lag. Usually wired connections are better, but they are less convenient or even impossible depending on your setup. So you have to choose wireless, try to go with 2.4 GHz instead of Bluetooth. Bluetooth is more popular and it doesn't need any dongles, but it tends to be slower. Your network could be, of course, the source of the lag. But in my experience, it's usually your first scapegoat, and most of the time it's not true. A little bit of lag is unavoidable, but if you've got a decent connection, don't just disregard your lag to your connection every time. In fact, if your connection was to blame, it is more common to have occasional stutters or halts as opposed to constant lag. This means at the very least, now and then it should work fine and with no delay. If that's not the case, then your connection is probably not the reason, or at least not the main reason for your input lag. If you do have temporary issues, then you will have to reconsider how the Wi-Fi signal reaches your TV set. You might need a Wi-Fi signal extender or a mesh, or simply try to reach with an Ethernet cable instead of using Wi-Fi. I will try to cover the different options in a video on the matter. Obviously, how your Android device performs, in many cases Google TV, is going to have an influence on input lag. Some of the display and system options may have a big effect on it too. So before you start cranking things up to 11, as we like to do with new things, make sure you're not putting yourself in a tricky situation. Namely, display options can have a big effect. There's a game mode in advanced settings that you need to enable, but also resolution and dynamic range will affect a lot, since it will enforce some settings in your TV that can affect lag. Modern smart TVs usually have a game mode into their settings. What this usually does is effectively disable many settings such as noise reduction or other kinds of image enhancement that are crippling your performance. That translates a lot more than you will think into input lag. If you can find a game mode in your TV menu, make sure it's not just being hidden by other options, including Google TV settings. In my case, I couldn't find it on my LG Smart TV because inadvertently I had enabled Dolby Vision on the display options and match content was off, meaning I was enforcing all my content on that format. Let me show you the actual effect of this. This first video shows my original input lag when I was accidentally enforcing 4K and Dolby Vision on my TV. The lag here is around 400 milliseconds for a Bluetooth controller and about 350 for a 2.4G controller. This is next to unplayable for platformers and first-person shooters and completely useless for racing games. And here is the performance when I realized I was able to use HD instead of Dolby and enable game mode on my TV. As you can see, the difference is huge. We're in the 150 milliseconds range now, which makes it quite useful for most genres. Racing games still suffer slightly, and only competitive first-person shooters would not be okay with this lag. So we are not quite on the traditional gaming input lag area yet, but more than enough for couch gaming in most games. I am pretty sure with a more modern TV I could reduce input lag under the 100 milliseconds mark. A service like GeForce Now Ultimate would probably take me even lower and into the 40 or 50 milliseconds range where input lag stops being noticeable. Also, changing Google TV for something like Nvidia Shield will probably help to reduce those times too. With my current settings, I'm able to play any game, including racing games, which are usually the ones that get most affected by lag. There's still a bit of it, but it's at a very acceptable level now. I am sure it will improve with time as I update the different elements. So there you have it. I hope all that info will help you beat input lag so that you can enjoy your games. Remember to like and subscribe for more information about cloud gaming in a relaxed setting.